Every day when I wake up, I can see his mercies all around me. And in every circumstance, his plans for me is to...
Well, grace and peace, and welcome to Fresh Start once again. God has blessed us with a brand new day. You know, I greet you in the strong name of the Lord Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. The Bible says that the name of the Lord is a strong tower the righteous run into and they are safe. And so we recognize that God has blessed us once again. He's brought us into a brand new day. And as we discovered on yesterday morning, God has daily loaded us with benefits. And so do me a favor. I know we did it on yesterday, but let's do it again this morning. And let's say, I am loaded. Come on, say, I am loaded. Put it in the chat area. I am loaded. Come on. Now, we've been in this series on prayer. I want you to go back with me to Luke chapter number 11, verse number 4, where the scriptures declare, and forgive us, again, this is the model prayer, forgive us our sins, for we also forgive everyone that is indebted to us. Catch this. Luke 11 and 4 says, and forgive us. We prayed about your will. We prayed about your kingdom come, your will be done. But we're also supposed to pray that we are forgiven of God because we are choosing to forgive other people. This is something we talked about several days ago. I don't want to delve into it in great detail, but I do want to remind us, those of us who appreciate God's grace and appreciate God's mercy, I know I do, I want to make mention of the fact that part of this model prayer and the framework that Jesus teaches his disciples on the subject of prayer, it includes us asking God to forgive us. Now, let me just pause and just give every last one of us a reality check. One, we've not made it. Two, we still have the baptism of the Holy Spirit because God is working on each and every one of us. And so with that being said, part of what we are to pray is that God forgives us. But in Luke's account, let me put it up on the screen. In Luke's account, he says, and forgive us our sins. Watch this. For we also forgive everyone that is indebted to us. Now, I want you to consider something for just a moment. Is there anyone in your life that owes you anything? Is there anyone in your life that owes you anything? Not just money. Do they owe you anything? And of those that still owe you something, whether it's money, an apology, time, a favor, and they have not done it, can you forgive them? Pause. Can you forgive the one, he says, that is indebted to you? The first part of the prayer, let me put it up on the screen. The first part of that prayer in verse number 4 says, God, we are praying that you forgive us. Why? For we also forgive everyone that is indebted to us. We are forgiving people that owe us, which tells me every time I step out of the will of God and I transgress the commandments and the will and the wishes of my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and I cross that line into sin, Scripture tells me in context that I owe God something. That even though he died on the cross and there is a such thing as the finished work of the cross, part of the finished work of the cross is us being able to come to him and ask him for help and to ask him to forgive us. And so part of that framework in prayer says, Lord, I need you to forgive me because I'm not always hitting the mark. And I need you to do this because I'm doing this for other people that owe me. And I know they owe me. And they know they owe me. They are, let me put it up on the screen. He says, we are forgiving everyone that is indebted to us. We've blessed other people. They have not blessed us back. We have given, they have not given back. But we are forgiving them. Notice what the text says in this fresh focus and in this perspective on prayer. Forgive me, Lord. Why? Because I'm choosing to forgive others. There's a scripture there in Ecclesiastes for those that take notes during Fresh Start. I want you to put this in your notes in Ecclesiastes chapter number 7 and verse number 12. It says, for there is not a just man upon the earth that doeth good and sinneth not. I'm not going to give much commentary on that. I want it to kind of sit there for itself. And I want you to ponder those words. There's not a just man on the earth that does good and does not sin. And so this tells me I can always go to God and ask God, Lord, forgive me. Because no matter how good or how just or justified I am, I'm still going to fall short of God's word and God's will for my life. It's not an excuse. It's a fact. And thank God we can go to him to realign ourselves with his will and with his way. Listen, that's all the time that I have for you today, but let's sit with Ecclesiastes, that verse there in Ecclesiastes. Let's sit with that verse today. Meditate on it. Think about it. Let's apply it to our lives and see how it shifts our time of prayer. God bless you. I'll see you in the morning.